Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Testing Mini Bytes. I am your friend Amudan Shaktivel, and in this video we will see about one of the amazing tool that's been running for a long time now, called a Selenoid. I'm wondering still why so many people didn't cover about Selenoid in their tutorials. So I thought, okay, I'll cover it in my particular videos. Good. So we have seen how to run our Selenium test inside the Docker containers using the Selenium grid. Right, so it has certain problems, right? So it has some problems it consumes more memory, it doesn't have any live execution preview. You have to download on VNC viewer, you have to attach to a port and other stuff, right? So, and also the execution, you don't have it in the form of videos, right? So in the latest version of Selenium 4, they are doing some advancements, like creating a video container and other stuff. But still, that's not mature enough to compete with Selenoid. Selenoid is a very, very mature tool, guys. I have tried that. It's very, very powerful. They have very good support through Telegram channels. They are also available as a form of cloud platforms like GCP, DigitalOcean, or Yandex Cloud as a ready-made product, right? So you can use them easily. And they have products like Moon and GoGrid Router, that is GGR, is very, very powerful, right? I'll cover this, if possible, but we'll see in detail about the Selenoid. Good. If you're wondering what is this Selenoid and other stuff, let's go to their official page and see. They have a very good documentation, maybe a little tricky to understand. That's why I am here to explain that in detail. Okay. And the thing that I want to show you guys is about Moon, right? So they have something, a product called as Moon, that is obviously paid tool. You have to spend some amount, but it's very, very simple, right? So if you just spend $5 for a session per month, right? So if you want to run 1,000 tests in parallel at single time, right, you need to spend, for 1 month, you need to spend, $5,000. It's very simple, guys. If you are having an infrastructure in your company, you don't have to maintain all of them. These guys will take care of all those things, right? So they do all the hard work, right? So I think a tool like Selenoid, it needs a pedestal in test automation industry. They are doing a lot of good work. They are giving very good support through Slack or Telegram channels as well. So I would like to cover this as part of our Selenium framework series, right? So let's also see how easy it is to do this, right? So we have worked with our, Selenium grid, right? So this is a normal test case that that we can run in our Selenium test, right? So to spin up our Selenium test, maybe I can open another workspace. Let me spin up those containers, right? So first we'll spin up those containers, okay? So I have opened a command prompt in this particular location where I have something called as selenium/docker/hyphen-compose.yaml, where it contains one Selenium hub, one node Chrome, and one node Firefox, right? So I'm just trying to spin it up. So docker-compose-f, if the name is different from docker-compose, you need to use the file name with the hyphen f, right? So Selenium, yes, up. So once you do this, you have your Selenium grid infrastructure up and running in few seconds, right? This is very, very cool. We have already seen about this, right? So let's wait for it to get up and running. I'll try to do a comparison between my Selenium grid as well as the Selenoid. Let's see what is better, right? So let me also go to the localhost 4444, and I think it is up and running now. So if I want to execute my test, right? So it's very, very simple. Okay, I just need to point it to this particular URL where my Selenium grid is up and running. That's localhost 4444. Good, guys, it's very, very simple. I'm launching my Google Chrome. I'm printing the title. I'm just entering testing mini bytes and pressing enter. And I'm also doing a thread.sleep for almost 5 seconds so that we can see the live execution. This will be really helpful if I have to execute here, right? So that's what it, I'm just quitting the browser. Again, whenever you are running it in Docker, always use quit instead of close, right? So quit will basically close your container, right? So that's very, very cool. Good, and click on run as test ng. So very, very simple test. It may take few seconds. Okay, the test will work absolutely fine, right? So everything works fine. But the thing is, we cannot see the execution, right? We need to download VNC Viewer, and then most importantly, we cannot get the recordings of the videos, right? So if I want to attach it into a Jira, I cannot do that because I don't have a video recording with me. But with the help of Selenite, it's very, very simple, right? So now we have seen about Selenium Docker, right? Selenium Grid with Docker. We'll also see about Selenite, right? So first, basically, let me stop the whole thing. Again, it's went to the listening mode. Let me create one more command from here and let me spin it down. So spinning down is also very simple. Docker hyphen compose, right? So hyphen F Selenium down, right? So down. It's very, very simple, guys. It'll spin down your whole infrastructure. This we have seen about in detail in the previous videos. If you haven't watched those, please do watch them, right? So I have explained each and everything in detail, right? So let me close all these things. Now the whole thing is down. If I reload this, there won't be any containers up and running, right? Good. Now we are going to spin up those Selenite containers, okay? So for that, you know, maybe I'll open my PowerShell. So because I'm gonna use variables, maybe I'll properties, let me increase the font size so that it's a little visible. Yeah, and then now I'm just entering this particular command because I'm going to create a variable. This variable is taking my present working directory, that is C users CSActivale, and then I'm replacing all the double slashes with this particular double slash and all the capital C with the small c's, right? So this I'm doing, right? So good. Once I did this, I can print this particular variable, okay? So it basically, instead of displaying all these things, right? So if I print $PWD, okay, it's gonna print it like this. So I'm actually converting in the form of this so that I can use it in the Docker commands, right? So because in Docker, we need to use a single \ instead of the forward slashes, right? So that's what I'm actually doing. Once you do this, okay, you can run a very simple command. So I'm just trying to explain all these things, right, in the next session. But for now, just to understand, we just need to copy a single command, paste it here. And I'm trying to spin up this ArrowCube Selenoid with all these particular things, right? So I will explain this in detail in the next video. But for now, just to understand, I ran this command. Once I ran this command, I can check the Docker PS and then see I have my Selenoid container that is up and running on 4444, which is actually mapped to the Docker container 4444. Once you do this, you can also spin up another container called as Selenoid UI, which from where you can see the live execution. That's very important, right? It's very simple command. Okay, I'm spinning up the container Selenoid UI, exposing the port 8090. Good. So if I have to expose this 8090, duplicate and 8090. If you notice, my 4444 is displaying you are running Selenoid 1.10. That's good. And I have a UI where I can see the live execution. Good. So okay, you can also have the tabs where I have my previous recording video, right? If I run this, this is the previous recording that I had before, right? So maybe I can delete this. Okay. I can delete this. I don't need this. Okay. And if you also notice, they have all these things, okay, which I have configured. Good, I'm choosing this. You can also get your whatever the desired capabilities that you have to use. Okay, if you don't know what the code you have to write, they have given a sample code. Okay, you can copy it and paste it here. The same code I have used. Okay, if you want to view the live execution, you have to enable this. If you want to save the video recording, you have to do this. If you want to give the video name a custom name, you can give it the name like this using this desired capability. And the entire thing after this remains the same. So here we are just passing only one capability. Here we are passing three capabilities. That's the only difference. Apart from that, the code looks almost the same. There is no difference in this. Let's try to run this whole test and then check what's happening. Okay, let me go here. And once you load this, you will see your live execution. Okay. See, there is a live execution now that's happening. Okay, so notice it's running my test. Testing many bytes is loading. It's waiting for 5 seconds and it closed, right? This is the Chrome container that opened, right? Everything is now fine. Now the same way, the video recordings will be accessible at this particular point. right? So this is the name of the video that I have given. If I try to run this, right, I should, this is the video recording, right? It's amazing, right? So you have the live execution. You can store this. It is also getting stored into your local directory. So whatever the directory that you mentioned, it will also be stored there. So if you notice, I have mentioned that to be stored in Aseptive Serenoid, and inside this, I want to store it inside video. That's how I have coded. You can code a different way, but if you code like this, you can also access this here. Suppose if I have a Jira, I need to attach this test execution. It's very, very simple. You don't need the screenshot. You don't need the reports. Everything is simple, guys, right? So it can run like this, okay? So you can run it from anywhere. You can access this using the endpoint, or you can access this from your local directory, right? So this is very, very fast as well. When compared to your Selenium Grid, it's very fast, very robust. We'll see more about it in the coming videos. I'll speak about this, for like almost two videos, next two videos. We'll go step by step. What are the things that you need to do, everything. So please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that. So, and keep supporting Testing Many Bytes. I'll see you all in another great video. Tata, bye-bye.